Hello everyone and welcome to LA's The Place. I'm Jeff Gaskin and I've been joined by Marianela. She is the host of ESPNU's Road Trip and VH1's new hit show Dance Cam Slam. Welcome to the studios.
Thank you for having me.
Well, thank you for being here. How did you get involved in so many shows and dancing?
Well, dancing is a passion from when I was very little. My parents were international tango dancers.
Really?
So at a very young age, I kind of toured the globe. Not like I remember any of it because I was 1, 2, and 3. But I basically made the backstage of many theaters my home when I toured with my parents. And finally, at the age of 5, they're like, okay, we need to settle her down somewhere. And my parents and I moved to the States. And I don't know if it was like a rebellious thing, but I'm like, I'm not going to tango dance. I'm going to be a classical ballerina. So I went the ballet route and I danced my whole life. And then in the States, I became a fan of like hip hop and through my sister, a fan of like salsa and merengue. So I literally just did it all. I was just like salsa, merengue, lambada, a little bit of tango with my dad, ballet. So that's where the dance background came from.
And from when I was very little, being Argentine, I was a huge football fan. I went to go see Diego Maradona play when I was 3. That I remember, interestingly enough. I'm like, I remember that moment. So,
and then coming to the States, I danced for University of Maryland, and I was on the sidelines for all the football games, and I was there when Steve Francis went to Maryland, and we were basketball champs.
Excellent. So good timing.
Yeah, I was like dancing, then I, you know, became a huge sports fan.
And when I started in the entertainment business, I was like, okay, how can I blend the two together?
Very good idea.
Now, ESPNU show Road Trip, this looks like the dream show for any sports fan. Basically, you guys go around to college towns where there's big rivalries going on,
yeah,
and you get immersed in all the behind-the-scenes action, right?
It's totally all the behind-the-scenes, and it's fun. It's not the X's and O's of game day, but it is, just like you said, it's behind-the-scenes. We, you know, we catch up with the coach. I mean, Mac Brown brought us into his office and showed us all of his, like, amazing souvenirs, and he was so sweet to us, even gave us
chocolate chip cookies. That's Southern hospitality.
True.
Thank you, Texas.
But yeah, I've been everywhere. We've been traveling since September 1st, and it's so much fun because we hang with the players, we go to practice, obviously on the sidelines for the game, but we also like to dive into like what that city has to offer.
Yeah.
The nightlife of wherever we are, and also traditions, school traditions, like at Texas Tech.
Where they like, you know, they mask everything in red tape.
Oh, that must
before
have been fun.
The game. Oh,
did they mask
so
you in
fun.
Red tape?
No.
I wanted to be a part of that, though. I wanted to mask Drubner in red tape. I'm like, this should be our next bit.
Yes, your co-host seems to take the brunt of a lot of the poking the fun at. I saw when you guys were in Wisconsin, he even shaved the Wisconsin W in the back of his head.
Yeah, actually, I pushed him to do that.
Very good.
I was like, Drub, you got to do the W.
Now, how did you get involved with VH1's Dance Cam Slam? Because this is a great show. It combines all the energy of a dance competition, but also, there's some reality to it because anyone can be a contestant.
Yeah, well, they picked me. Obviously, I'm a huge fan of dancing, but I also like people that can have a good time and, you know, not take themselves so seriously.
Yeah.
And it's got that whole interactivity element where it's got the Skype. I mean, these people are literally in the comfort of their own homes,
yeah,
cranking on their webcams and competing for a chance at $5,000. And I like that there's no like celebrity component like Dancing with the Stars. But they don't take themselves that seriously. But I feel like, hey, if you're a dance lover, you should have the opportunity to show your passion for dancing and, you know, be creative and fun. I mean, the people that won the first week, the chocolate chip dancers,
love these guys. Like 3 black guys with their huge bellies hanging out.
They were sporting their bow ties. And the best part was like the whole time they were having so much fun while they were doing it. And America fell in love with them because it works. Dance Cam Slam works in 3 rounds, like 5 people are in round 1, our judges pick a winner. Round 2, another 5 compete, the judges pick a winner. And then in round 3, America votes.
And that's really cool because unlike some of the dance competition shows, you don't have to wait till the end of the season for a winner to be crowned. Every week, someone's going to win $5,000.
Every week, cha-ching, somebody's taking home 5 grand. So that's not a bad deal for just like, you know, getting down and funky.
From the comfort of your own living room.
Or a kitchen. Some people dance from their kitchen. Sometimes it gets weird.
And I noticed there's a lot of variety, too. Sometimes you get, like, hip-hop dancers, but I've seen ballroom dancers on there. How do you guys pick the contestants?
Actually, I don't have anything to do with that process. I think that's something the producers do from all the videos that get uploaded online.
So
that's
why I show you my reel of dancing?
Please show me your reel.
You don't want to see it.
I want to see everything. I've seen it all.
I don't think you can surprise me at this point, but
that's true.
Do they try to pick contestants based on more personality, or do you think they're looking more for their actual dance style?
Well, that's what's difficult, because I always get asked, like, oh, how do you make it through? Like, how do you make it through as, like, a round one winner mm-hmm. and a round two winner? And it really, I'm just like, guys, I don't do the judging. I mean, we have one professional choreographer,
Brandon Henshaw, and then Jordan Feldman, he's sort of like our style expert. And I mean, you could be wearing a Barney suit and Jordan may be into it. You know what I mean? Or you could be wearing, like, you may have like lavender roses around and he's just like, I love the lavender.
I don't know what the judges are going to be into. Obviously, Brandon being a professional choreographer, he's looking for some kind of dancing ability.
Yes. So you're not going to get through unless you can't just be like bouncing around in a giraffe outfit. Like, you have to actually bring some element of dance to the table.
All right, I'm taking notes.
Yeah, but it's just cool that you really don't have to be...
I mean, sometimes the trained dancers get through, mm-hmm. but sometimes like the chocolate chip dancers that are just letting their bellies hang out. I mean, they really did choreograph a whole routine.
Yeah.
But it's just fun to be like, you know, they don't care about what's hot or what's not. People are just being creative, being fun, and being themselves. And it's really whatever America's into, because at the end of the day, they're the ones that are delivering, cha-ching, the $5,000.
That is true. Well, Marianela, you seem like you're a pretty busy woman hosting two shows on two big networks. And I've also heard you made appearances on CNN, you've made appearances on NBC, and even on ER, correct?
Yes.
Does the changing room at ER still reek of George Clooney?
It still massively reeks of George Clooney.
I bet it did.
I was there when they were actually, it was like the end. It was like the last mm-hmm. season. And it's just funny because I come from a family of doctors. Oh, so after the ER episode, I was like, I called home to Argentina. I'm like, abuelito. I'm like, grandpa. I'm like, have I made you proud? I made it onto ER. When I was in school, I actually worked at the National Institute of Mental Health. I was going to go very much like the medicine route. And then I was like, no, I'll host a live show from New York. That sounds like a lot more fun.
It does. Well, did you use family members as consultants for your parts on ER?
Absolutely. I'm like, listen, Grandpa. So when they stick the IV into my arm, no. Give me notes. Give me pointers.
Nice. Well, what's the future hold for Marianela?
I really don't know what the future holds. I'm the kind of girl where I'm just like, hey, whatever door opens, you know, as long as I'm interested and I'm passionate about it, I dive right into it. As of right now, I'm pretty busy with both shows, so it doesn't leave, you know, a lot of time open for anything else. But, you know, I'm hoping to be the Latina, you know, Kelly Ripa. I'm really into the live format, so.
Yeah, that's fun.
And I have a lot to say. So, I'm pretty opinionated. I'd love to get into another live show. That would be awesome. And anything that has to do with food, too. I'm a huge food connoisseur and lover.
Are you? Are you a cook?
I cook.
Really?
I was so spoiled. I grew up with my grandmother, and being Argentinian, but our ancestors are from Spain. It's like mm-hmm. the cuisine at my house was always Argentine, but with the Spaniard roots, and then with like a little Italian zest, and I was so spoiled. My friends were like eating peanut butter and jelly, and I had like, you know, like amazing Argentine steak with like mashed potatoes.
Ooh, were you one of those kids where your friends would magically come over at dinner time every day? Oh, just
not
pop
magically.
In.
They would just be like, Marianela, did your grandmother cook something?
That's great. Well, what are some of your favorite dishes?
Oh my goodness, I have so many. I love so many cuisines. I'm a huge fan of Mediterranean food. Ooh, nice. Something I cook something I make almost every day is my own garlic hummus with lemon.
Ooh.
Chickpeas, organic chickpeas.
You gotta go organic.
Olive oil, lemon, tons of garlic, and then a little paprika on top, and some pine nuts.
I've always wondered how they make hummus.
Yeah, this is how Marianela makes hummus. It's the best. It's better than the restaurants, I'm telling you.
Awesome. I should make my own brand. But yeah, I love so many foods, it's hard to pick. Like, I love Italian, I love French. Obviously, being Argentine, I love me some good steak.
There you go.
So yeah.
Well, what else do you do in your free time? Because it seems like you're pretty busy, but when the shows aren't shooting, where are we going to find Marianela?
On my couch, sleeping.
Oh.
And diving into my Netflix. I'm a huge fan of my Roku box.
Yeah?
I was like a giggly little kid. I was like the best Christmas present I ever got myself. I went online and I'm like, I'm gonna get me my Roku box.
I don't even know what Roku box is.
Oh my, it's amazing.
You can stream instantly online. So if you're a member of Netflix, like I pay $8 a month mm-hmm. and I literally have so many movies that I can watch instantly.
No waiting for the mail to come?
No waiting for the mail. I also get them in the mail, but they just pop right up, and I'm a huge fan of like documentaries and foreign films. So on my downtime, which isn't very often, but when I do have some downtime,
this is me on my couch. I'm just like, and eating my hummus.
What kind of shows are you watching? Do you watch dance shows and sports shows, or are you just trying to get that stuff cleared out of your mind in your free
There's
time?
There's so much dance and sports going on in my life. On my free time, I'm literally watching like Federico Fellini, foreign films, and a lot of documentaries.
Cool.